Welcome to High School Roundup here on CUTV. My name is Peyton Trollinger, and alongside of me, I'm joined with Jonathan Sakaguchi. How are you doing today?
Doing good, Peyton, especially after this week of matchups. As you can see by my outfit, I'm decked head to toe in maroon and white, as for the first time since 2016, and Uniontown has won their first game. And but we'll get more into that later on, and because I have actually got a special little thing for that. So what do you say, Peyton? Let's jump right into it.
I'm very excited. I bet you're also very excited as well. All right, let's get right into it. We're going to get into the scores of this previous week. Johnny, take it away.
All right, hey, take a look at our first set of matchups here as Bentworth beat Frazier in a close one. 20-19 is your final score of that one. In a close one over there at Frazier High School. Then we get a look at the second matchup. Up as California dominated at 49-7 over Waynesburg Central. Oh, and that was actually one of our games of the week. Let's take a look at the next set of scores.
All right, and then we have Herrick High School traveling to Uniontown. As we just stated, Uniontown getting their first win in since 2016, 41-6, a very convincing win, by the way.
And very big win and for Coach Jeffries, his first as a head coach over there. Here, but we'll talk more about that in a minute.
Congrats to him. And my Charleroi Cougars traveling just across the bridge over to Manesson High School, where the Greyhounds just absolutely upset the Cougars 24-6. And I'm not very happy with that. But Manesson, they played a good game, and you got to give it to them. Let's go to the next set of scores here.
This one, and we had Chartiers Houston. And taking on Mapletown, Chartiers Houston dominated this one as the Buccaneers went in convincingly a 44-15. Then Derry area traveled up to Indiana High School where the Tribe comes away with a large margin of victory as they win 70-15. And let's take a look at the next set of scores here.
Man, that's a big difference. And we have some more big differences in scores. Jefferson Morgan traveling to Cornell, where they will end up losing 52-8. Wow. And then we have another one here. Laurel Highlands playing Gary's Brownsville Falcons. Falcons not able to come up with a win, actually getting shut out 65-0. And I'm sure Gary's just not happy with that at all.
No, if you can see, he's shaking his head over there inside the control room. But take a look at our next set of scores. Northern and Garrett High from Maryland and taking on Albert Gallatin. AG picking up the win in this one, 33-13. And then you had Norwood and traveling down 119 to go play Connellsville High School. Oh, Norwood comes up with a win, 37-0. Take a look at the next set of scores.
All right, we have an upset here. We have Penn Trafford traveling to Bell Vernon High School, where an absolute upset occurred. We had the Leopards just slaying Penn Trafford 27-7. And then we also had Ringgold going to South Allegheny. Weren't able to get a score on that.
I believe, even I last looked, South Allegheny picked up the win of that one. I don't have the score in front of me. But South Allegheny's got the win over Ringgold. Take a look at this set of scores here. Here is Trinity traveled over to Yawk High School. Oh, as the Hillers defeat the Cougars 41-6. West Green traveled down to Beth Center, and this was another close, tight-knit battle as West Green pulls off the victory 38-30, and that was an upset at this week, Peyton, after we saw all Beth Center 2 weeks ago. In that close battle against Cal High, both the games that Beth Center's lost have been close, tight-knit games.
That can be a good thing. So at least if they're losing, then it's in close margin. So, like I said, if I were to lose, I'd rather lose in close fashion.
I'm a little different on that one, but
yeah. So we don't have any more scores. So what we're gonna do? We're gonna send it to break, and we'll be right back after these short messages.
Looking for something to do? Then don't miss the 2021 Health Fair. This year, the Health Fair will be on Wednesday, October 6th in the Convocation Center Arena from 11 a.m. until 2 p.m. There will be free STD testing, a blood drive, prizes, free health screens, flu and COVID vaccines, giveaways, and much, much more. Don't miss the excitement. Be at the Convocation Center on October 6th for the 2021 Health Fair.
The Cal-U Cupboard connects students to information, services, and resources both on and off campus while providing free items such as food, school supplies, personal hygiene items, and more to our students. Visit our two locations at the Vulcan Village Clubhouse and Italy Student Center, or for a contactless option, visit bit.ly.com/Cal-U Cupboard to request food or give donations. For important Cal-U information, community resources, and our how-to series, follow at Cal-U Cupboard on Instagram and the campus-wide announcements.
Okay, Daddy. Dr. Elmo says you're healthy.
Oh, well, thank you. Our children and families want us to be healthy. That's why I and lots of other grown-ups got the COVID-19 vaccine, so we can stay healthy and get back to the moments we miss, like seeing our friends and family.
Here you go, Daddy. For a healthy checkup, a sticker.
Oh, thanks, son.
With free COVID-19 vaccines, sunnier days are ahead. Visit GetVaccineAnswers.org.
Vulcan Volleyball is back, and you can catch all the action with CUTV and the PSAC network. After a year away from the court, the Vulcans are set to try and get back to the top of the PSAC. A full slate of action versus such PSAC opponents: Gannon, Mercyhurst, Edinburgh, Clarion, Seton Hill, Slippery Rock, IUP, and Pitt Johnstown. Every home game will be live on CUTV Sports 1 and the PSAC network.
Welcome back to High School Roundup here on CUTV. Before the break, we left off with the scores, and we have a very important score that we need to talk about a little bit more. Uniontown coming up with the win over Carrick, 41-6.
Yeah. It was a bit in a long time coming for this one, and Uniontown had a coaching change earlier this year. Coach Jeffries, who's originally one of the assistant coaches for Uniontown, stepped in this as the head coach this year. We're bringing back a couple other coaches and some other new names. As Uniontown last week one, started off the season a little rough as they lost to their first two games of the year, but after that, came back and started what I thought was a strong victory. I even had some friends of mine at Uniontown on send some stuff in which, by the way, thank you to the Tomahawk Talk and the Uniontown faithful over there for the images and a couple videos that they sent to us. Thank you guys. Greatly appreciate it. One photo I wish they would have sent me that I didn't get was the student section was out in full force, as that section was packed and started even flooding into the reserved area.
Wow.
Yeah, of Bill Power Stadium. And from what I was told from a couple people, that cheerleaders, the students section, and the band member stormed the field. I don't condone that. I get it. You guys are excited, but chill out a little bit. But congratulations to Uniontown on the big victory. Actually see a couple old family members coming off the field in this video here. So shout out to those guys there. But overall, congratulations to Uniontown on picking up a big victory against a school that's from the City League, which, let's be honest, Pittsburgh schools coming down to here. Uniontown hasn't had the best track record against them. And mm-hmm. I can say that. I played for them. We lost to West Mifflin. We lost to a couple other schools, TJ. Hey, and I'm trying to think of some other schools we played, Franklin Regional, and all those guys that Uniontown's played. Hey, this has been a long time coming that they needed. Uniontown went to independent because they thought it would help them start to grow the program back to being a good football school again. And they've not made the playoffs since my sophomore year, which was 2011.
Wow.
Or 2010. And for that season when they lost to Hampton. And they've been looking for a way to get something started, and I think this is the way the program is looking to get things started. And looking to keep this winning thing going up coming up this week. Well, we'll talk about that when we get to the schedules. Well, let's jump into that now. What do you say, Peyton?
Let's get right into those schedules for the upcoming week. We have, for the 1A Tri-County South Conference, we have Avella traveling to Jefferson Morgan, Cal High traveling to West Green. We have a game of the week here. We have Carmichael's going to Mapletown, and then we have Manesson traveling to Bentworth. And then let's take a look at some other games that are going to be coming up this Friday.
So let's take a look here at the 1A Eastern Conference. Bishop of Gavin heads over to Springdale. Oh, Amani Christian and travels over to Greensburg Central Catholic, Leechburg at Clarendon, and Riverview at Jeanette. Let's take a look at the next set of schedules.
And for the Century Conference 2A play, we have Best Center traveling to Chartiers, Houston. We have the lovely Charleroi Cougars going to McGuffey to play the Highlanders. And then we have the Washington Prexies traveling to Waynesburg Central. Let's take a look at some more games that are going to be coming up on this Friday.
Another one, game of the week here at 3A Interstate 8 Conference matchup play. Elizabeth Forward at Brownsville will be out there this Friday. Hey, Peyton, you'll be on the call for that one. We have South Allegheny versus Southmoreland High School. Well, the Scotties playing host to their first conference game of the year. And South Park travels over to Yawk. Let's take a look at the next set of games coming up this week.
And then for 4A play, the Greater Allegheny Conference, we have Armstrong traveling to Hampton. We have another game of the week here, Greensburg, Salem versus Knock. And then we have Highlands versus Mars. And then last, we have Plum traveling to Indiana. I think we still have some more games that are going to be coming up this Friday.
That we do.
Yes, we do.
Big 8 play in the 4A level. Oh, Bell Vernon travels over to West Mifflin, which I think is going to be an interesting matchup. Another game of the week right here, Laurel Highlands travels just up the road here from California to play Ringgold. And Trinity E going to Thomas Jefferson. Let's take a look at the next set of games coming up this week.
And for last but not least, our non-conference / independent games. We have Connellsville traveling to Kiski area. Local team Fraser traveling to Ligonier Valley. We also have Mount Pleasant going to Latrobe. Quaker Valley traveling to Brentwood, excuse me. And then we have the Uniontown Raiders traveling to Albert Gallatin.
And that Uniontown game is another game of the week, and that one is for the George C. Marshall Memorial Trophy. The first game that played, I can safely say I was a part of that first time they had that.
Okay.
And I wish we had the picture for it, as Uniontown came away with the win, and I had played a big role in that one on catching the two-point conversion, which actually became a big reason in that Uniontown won that game.
All right, okay.
Back in 2011, and for my senior season. But it's good to see that rivalry still going, and I cannot wait for that. We'll just talk about those picks later on.
A lot of very good matchups coming up this Friday, and we'll talk a little bit more when we come back, and we see you after the break.
Looking for something to do? Then don't miss the 2021 Health Fair. This year, the Health Fair will be on Wednesday, October 6th in the Convocation Center Arena from 11 a.m. until 2 p.m. There will be free STD testing, a blood drive, prizes, free health screens, flu and COVID vaccines, giveaways, and much, much more. Don't miss the excitement. Be at the Convocation Center on October 6th for the 2021 Health Fair.
The Cal-U Cupboard connects students to information, services, and resources both on and off campus while providing free items such as food, school supplies, personal hygiene items, and more to our students. Visit our two locations at the Vulcan Village Clubhouse and Italy Student Center, or for a contactless option, visit bit.ly.com/Cal-U Cupboard to request food or give donations. For important Cal-U information, community resources, and our how-to series, follow at Cal-U Cupboard on Instagram and the campus-wide announcements.
Okay, Daddy, Dr. Elmo says you're healthy.
Well, thank you. Our children and families want us to be healthy. That's why I and lots of other grown-ups got the COVID-19 vaccine, so we can stay healthy and get back to the moments we miss, like seeing our friends and family.
Here you go, Daddy, for a healthy checkup, a sticker.
Oh, thanks, son.
With free COVID-19 vaccines, sunnier days are ahead. Visit getvaccineanswers.org.
Vulcan Volleyball is back, and you can catch all the action with CUTV and the PSAC network. After a year away from the court, the Vulcans are set to try and get back to the top of the PSAC. A full slate of action versus such PSAC opponents: Gannon, Mercyhurst, Edinburgh, Clarion, Seton Hill, Slippery Rock, IUP, and Pitt Johnstown. Every home game will be live on CUTV Sports 1 and the PSAC network.
Welcome back to High School Roundup here on CUTV. I'm also joined with Jonathan Sakaguchi. Then we've just been kicking it here in the studio, haven't we?
Yeah, it's been a great episode so far, Peyton. A lot to talk about out so far, and we got more to talk about still. But let's jump into conference standings now, because there's a lot to go over.
Yes, sir.
But we'll start here in the Tri-County South Conference. California has the sole possession of that lead. They are the only unbeaten team in that conference at 2-0. Oh, Carmichael's and Mapletown on tied for second place right now at 2-1. Bentworth sitting at 500 in the fourth spot. Manesson and West Green tied for the fifth spot in the conference right now, all at 1-2. And sitting there at the bottom of the conference right now, Lavella and Jefferson Morgan still searching for that first win of the year, or at 0-3.
Hopefully that comes very soon for them. And I know we have way more standings than this to go over, so let's go over them. The 2A Century Conference, we have the Washington Prexies sitting on top, 3-0. Sharptears Houston also unbeaten, but they are 2-0. McGuffey and Waynesburg Central not far behind them. 1-2 is their record. And Best Center and Charleroi have not picked up a win yet, and they are 0-2. And Frazier sitting at the bottom of the Century Conference with 0-3.
Yeah, and I guarantee you all three of those teams are going to be looking in for some redemption this week, especially Beth Center after losing two close ones. Take a look at the next conference standings here. So we go to the Interstate Conference, and it's Mount Pleasant and Southmoreland tied for the first place spot at 2-1. Elizabeth Forward, who we'll see this Friday at 1-2. Right behind them is Brownsville on South Park at 0-2. And sitting at the bottom of the conference, tied for fifth, is South Allegheny and Yawk at 0-3. But I guarantee we're going to see some conference shuffling this week with all these different matchups, especially having EF playing Brownsville and South Park traveling over to Southmoreland. So it'll be interesting to see on that one. Take a look at the next conference.
All right, we have the 4A Big 8 Conference. LH and McKeesport out at the top at 3-0. This is a very good conference, as you can see. And then we have it tied for third in the division. We have Bell Vernon and Thomas Jefferson sitting at 2-0 apiece. Ringgold, the only one, at 2-1. And Trinity and West Mifflin are tied at the bottom for 1-2.
Yeah, I guarantee this conference, I guarantee we're going to see a lot of movement this week. We have LH going to Ringgold. Old Bell Vernon and playing host to TJ. And Trinity, he's got, I believe we said McKeesport, or no, Trinity has Thomas Jefferson. But there's going to be a lot of movement in this one. We're going to have to look at this one real close next week.
This is going to be a very interesting conference to watch over this week.
Take a look now here at the 5A Big East Conference. And as Gateway sits atop the conference at 2-1, on with Penn Trafford tied for first. Franklin Regional on Latrobe, as well as Woodland Hills at 1-2. Connellsville, the lone team at the bottom, sitting at 0-3. Connellsville still looking for that first one. Might pick it up this week against Kiskey area.
I know they're really going to be trying, because, you know, all these teams have to get a win at least some point. I know they're not intentionally trying to lose, obviously. You know, they're just trying their best, but you got some really good teams this year, especially. Whenever we come back, we're going to be talking about the CUTV Game of the Week and our personal pick'ems right after the break.
Vulcan Volleyball is back, and you can catch all the action with CUTV and the PSAC network. After a year away from the court, the Vulcans are set to try and get back to the top of the PSAC. A full slate of action versus such PSAC opponents, Gannon, Mercyhurst, Edinburgh, Clarion, Seton Hill, Slippery Rock, IUP, and Pitt Johnstown. Every home game will be live on CUTV Sports 1 and the PSAC network.
Welcome back to High School Roundup here on CUTV. I am still joined with Jonathan Sakaguchi. We're just chilling in the studio like we all were this entire time. And now we're going to go over our pick-ems. We love this here on High School Roundup, a little competition we like to do here in the suite. And here we have the standings. Johnny sitting undefeated at 5-0. Very impressive by Johnny. Then we have Dylan, who is an alumni of CUTV, 3-2, tied with Doug at 3-2. I am tied, it's a three-way tie for fourth place. We have myself, Colin Kirkwood, and Bobby tied at 2-3, and Gary. Gary is just, he's not doing good. He's 1-4.
Rough start for Gary, but here's the thing. I've learned this from past seasons of High School Roundup. Don't count Gary out just yet. And after talking to Bobby D, he is a little frustrated after his picks from last week, but he's looking to bounce back. And mark the calendar, because I guarantee you this is the only time I'm ever going to go perfect on pick-ems.
Yeah, we might see Johnny's first loss this week, but I don't think he wants to jinx it just yet.
So here are our games of the week. It's EF at Brownsville. Oh, and that'll be our game of the week. We'll talk more about that in a moment. Greensburg-Salem at Knox. Laurel Highlands at Ringgold. Uniontown Owen at AG for the George C. Marshall Memorial Cup. Up and Carmichael's at Mapletown. Owen, Peyton, we'll start with your picks, and then we'll go through everyone else's as we got them here.
All righty. So I chose Elizabeth Ford to win over Brownsville. I chose Greensburg-Salem. I chose Laurel Highlands, Uniontown, and I also chose Carmichael's as well.
All right. Hey, my picks this week, I had Elizabeth Ford. I'm going with Knox as well. Oh, give me Laurel Highlands against Ringgold. Uniontown, I'm looking for them to keep this momentum train rolling here, folks. And I'm going with Mapletown with the upset over Carmichael's.
Ooh, okay. A little scandalous pick. Okay.
Yeah. Some other picks that we got in for this week. Go with Gary, our producer, first, since he's here in the studio with us. He's picking Brownsville over EF. He's going with his Brown. He's faithful to the Falcons.
Of course he is.
He also picked Greensburg-Salem, Ringgold, Uniontown, and Carmichael's.
Okay.
I know you have another set of picks, too.
I do. I have Doug Glacky's picks. So let's get through this. We have Doug picked Elizabeth Ford. He picked Knox, Laurel Highlands, Uniontown, and he picked Carmichael's. So, yeah, we have a few of the same picks. I think the only one that's different, he just picked Knox over Greensburg-Salem, but yeah.
Yeah, Bobby ED's picks also came in. And thanks, Bob, by the way. He picked Elizabeth Forward, Greensburg, Laurel Highlands, Albert. He's going with Albert Gallatin on this one.
Ooh, okay.
And Carmichael's. Colin and Dylan also sent their picks in. As Colin picked Elizabeth Forward, Knox, Laurel Highlands, AGE, and Carmichael's. Dylan's picks were EF, Greensburg, Ringgold with the upset.
Okay.
At Uniontown, and he said in all caps, Carmichael's all the way.
Wow. All right. Dylan's very confident with Carmichael's. And I noticed a trend there. You want to know what that trend was? Everybody picked Elizabeth Ford. The only one that didn't pick Elizabeth Ford was Gary.
And if Brownsville pulls off the upset, Gary's going to be the only man laughing at that one.
Mm-hmm.
But
and that'll,
I wouldn't mind seeing the upset, though.
I wouldn't either. That would be, it'd be very, interesting. I wouldn't expect it, though.
Speaking of which, folks, that is our game of the week as EF will be traveling down to Brownsville. Oh, if we can get that graphic for our game of the week that we will be at Peyton. I know you're going to be on the call with a newcomer.
Yes, Finn is going to be on the call with me.
A newcomer for that one. Well, and it's going to be an interesting one, though.
Yes, very. Elizabeth Ford has a lot of weapons. Brownsville is Brownsville. They're going to try. They're going to play. And they're going to have some football. That's what's going to happen.
But once again, Peyton, it's another good week of football coming up.
It is a very good week of football. And unfortunately, our time here has come to an end. I would like to thank everybody that has helped produce the show, Gary and everyone else in the back, for my broadcast partner, Jonathan Sakaguchi. My name is Peyton Trollinger, and have a great day.